opening night of season four of the World Series of Boxing. All eyes were on Mexico City, where the Mexico Guerreros took on the Cuba Domadores. Cuba for the first time in this national competition. Five weights to be decided tonight. The light flyweights up to 49 kilos. The bantam weights 56 kilos. The light welters, the middleweights and the heavyweights. Well, first out, Yosbany Villatia Soto, third at the recent World Championships. He took on the Mexican Yoselito Velasquez Altamirano. Well, typically the Mexican put up a brave performance against one of the best boxers in the world. Round after round went to the Cuban until a cut in the fifth and final round ended the light flyweight contest. Cuba, 1-0 on the night so far.
Yosbany Beitia.
All three judges have had it the way of the Cuban. On with the second fight, the bantamweights, 56 kilos. Brian Gonzalez stepping in for Aaron Alameda on the night, up against the Olympic champion. Well, there's Gonzalez entering, but it was Ramirez Carasana who was doing all of the work. The Olympic champion on fine form throughout the bout was in total dominance. A perfect demonstration of bantamweight boxing from Ramirez. He took every single round, some rounds by 10-9, others by 10-8.
Decisión unánime de los domadores de Cuba, Robesi
Ramirez. Well, people worried about the Cubans entering this contest, and so they should be. Up against the tough Mexicans after just two bouts, 2-0 up. The next fight, Romero against Toledo in the light welterweight. Juan Romero, a very tough WSB fighter, four wins and one loss last year, takes on Yasnir Toledo Lopez, second at the recent World Championships. Red hot favorite, the Cuban, did not have it all his own way, winning a tough first round, but then the Mexican pulled it back in round two and three. It went to the wire. Round five would be the decider.
Cuba,
who would win?
2-1
was the score.
Toledo.
Just was the answer. Toledo Lopez Yasnir making it 3-0 for Cuba. On then to the middleweights. And Juan Antonio Mercado pulled out, leaving Diego Moreno to have to fight for Mexico. He's up against the Pan-American champion, Ramon Luis Nicolas. A big ask for Moreno, who's only had a few international bouts. This middleweight 75 kilo class was pretty one-sided in the end. Ramon Luis Nicolas putting on a brilliant display of boxing. Well, the young 21-year-old Mexican did his best. He flew in from California late on a call-up.
Domadores de Cuba,
but in the end, every single judge went with every round to Ramon Luis Nicolas. Cuba, 4-0. Things were looking bad for Mexico. The final bout then, the heavyweights. And the Mexicans had brought in a Frenchman to compete for their team, Gabriel Coupe, to take on Arislande Savon Cortija. Well, Coupe's a big hitter, number two in France, a fair import, but he's up against the nephew of Felix Savon, the great three times Olympic champion. And look at his nephew, has the power that his uncle has too. A knockdown in round one, and then by the end of the first round, they threw in the towel. They'd had enough, perhaps an injury, perhaps they wanted no more. But the Cubans took 5-0 on the night. Savon Cortija Arislande finishing it off in style. So that is it. Cuba have hit the world stage running. They came with a fearsome reputation. They are to be feared.